These are inexpensive stainless steel sleeve anchors. They're manufactured here in Taiwan. You can find them in many hardware stores. They're made in either 200 series or 304 stainless steel. They don't have any particular markings on them. They might have stamped on them LK, and if they're 304, it'll say 3 or 304 on them. They have a smooth sleeve. There's no raised nubs on them. They come in a variety of diameters and lengths. A similar style, they sell with a hex bolt on top and a removable cone. This removable cone, though, it's magnetic, meaning it has iron in it, and it will actually rust. I'm not a fan of these. There's no certifications, ratings, or spec sheets that I'm aware of. I know that they've been installed by climbers and others in the river tracing and canyoning community. In our brake tests, I chose 2.5 and 4 inch long. Here's our test results with the ring eye nut. These I pulled out of the river, nearby river crag. This one pulled in sheer. The nut will start to deform around a few km. Snipped off. Here's our hole. 20, almost 28. I'm gonna try to reuse the same cap. That's a first, haven't broke one of those yet. Ooh, well, what the heck, 36.
$34.15.
Rock here broke, almost 29 kilonewtons. The steel carabiner I was using broke. Here's the results. Bolt pulled out. On that was 38.5. Snipped off, here's the head, 43.59.
We got good initial results, so I was curious under what circumstances could these fail. And we still got around 30 km in with the ring nut.
This time we're gonna use a 13 millimeter drill bit, an oversized hole. All right, duty hole, and a little wet. 24.64. This is one of the old bolts I got out of Liang.
So it looks like
34.05.
We also tested the bolts with hangers.
30.22.
Bolt sheared off, the hole 28.5 km.
So all the bolts we tested so far broke above 24 km. These ring eye nuts have been surprisingly strong. So yeah, all is good, right? You just saw some regular old hardware store bolt break just as strong as rated bolts. Well, up until they didn't. Which is why you need to watch this following video.
I've actually used these bolts in route development as temporary bolts or directionals, and then put glue-ins in the old holes. I also use them for trail making when needing to pole or better position large rocks. But they're not certified or rated, so I have strong reservations installing them as permanent hardware and seeing them used as such. Which is why I've already removed and replaced the few we had installed locally in the past.